learning to listen again. As you rest back into the floor with your right hand on your tummy, be in your magical, safe space again. I want you to imagine there's a child who's been hidden from the world, who's been hiding, waiting for someone to come and listen to them. Slowly, they're walking towards you. They look just like you did when you were their age. Can you see them? See them in your mind's eye. What are they wearing? How do they look? Do they like this magical place you've created? Look gently into their eyes. Are they pleased to see you? Or are they still a little sad? They want to tell you something. Do you know? Can you guess? They're upset, but they're frightened to tell. Is it safe? Is it safe to tell? Will you listen? Are you there for them as they start to tell? Breathe gently with them as they start to tell you what's been hurting them for so long. They wish it hadn't happened. Even after all this time, they wish it had never happened. They did the best they could to cope on their own. There was no one they could tell. Their way of dealing with it helped them survive. But they're still hurting. It felt so unfair. So wrong, so unkind. They know they didn't deserve it. They tried to deal with it on their own. They tried to work it out. They tried to pretend it didn't happen. But they still remember. It's been a secret for so long. A secret they swore to themselves they would keep forever. No one was ever to know. But it still hurts. It still feels so unjust. It wasn't their fault. But it still hurts. They never, ever talked about it. Not to anyone. But they wish they could. Just once. They wish more than anything to find someone who they can really trust, who will stop whatever they're doing and really listen. Not to laugh at them. Not to make them feel stupid. Not to judge them as an awful human being. But to show them some real compassion. To reassure them and promise them, if it ever happens again, they'll help them deal with it in a better way. A way that won't leave them feeling so lonely. Please, will you listen? Please. can they tell? Are you listening? Can you hear them? Can you bring yourself to say you really feel compassion for how they feel? Can you reassure them that if it does happen again, you'll be there for them to help to deal with it in a better way? One that won't leave them feeling so lonely. You know who they are. They're the best friend you ever had. Even though they're so young, they've done all they can to protect you from the cruelties of this world. They're that part of you, the part who's been so frightened, so terrified for so many years. The part of you who's been so hurt and so sad that no one has ever listened to them. They've longed to find someone whom it was safe to tell. Someone who would help them to release all the energy that's been locked up inside and got in the way of having a really happy life. They want to feel again that wonderful feeling of harmony and safety. The feeling they had when they were very young. They need to know you'll be there for them. You'll help them to make it all right. They need to know it's safe to come out and play again. That it's safe to be loved. You're not alone with what you may be feeling. Be elated. Finally, you've been heard. Breathe into this feeling of elation. If you're feeling tearful, know the emotion you've held inside has finally been released. Feel happy that at last you can look after each other on the next stage of your life. No one can ever hurt either of you ever again. Your secret isn't secret anymore. It's lost its power over you. There's nothing to be afraid of ever again. There is no more fear. You will survive with a little help from your young friend. Finally, you can talk to that part of you that knows better than you do how to find your feeling of harmony and equilibrium. A feeling that's eluded you for so long. Gently reach out your hand to this very special person in your life. Feel their small hand in yours, knowing you will face the world together from now on.